Hello, in this tutorial I'm going to be showing you how to do health. I'll be doing it where I'm controlling like the mouse and I'll click on the player and then its health will go down. This can be incorporated to like for when you get hit by bullets or an enemy pounces on your face or whatever. I mean, I don't know what your game's gonna do. Health tutorial. So perfectly. Right, so first things first, I'm going to add in the content. Don't know why I'm going to do it first. I usually forget and then I run it and it says, no, this will not work. Oh la la. Right. Add in a new class. This will be the player class. It's going to be pretty basic. Probably better than the first class I ever created, but that's because back in those days of class making, nobody knew. Nobody. Especially David Rogers, Merkinson, Son, and Madden. I'm just mumbling to myself now. Right, let's get that guaning going on. Right, public int. Oh, what is that? Health. I'm going to make the rectangle public as well. Public player. Three parameters will be the texture, position, and health. I don't like this new keyboard, I don't like it at all. Right. Okay. Public void update. I won't be moving the player or anything. It's just going to be loading up the rectangle. That's all I'm going to be doing here. Done? Am I done there? Yes, yes I am. And now drawing. I'm gonna spice up this draw today. You never know what's about to happen. About to get slapped in the face by newness. If health is more than zero, then I will draw it. So that means if I've got health left, then I'm on the screen. Otherwise, I disappear. What I would do if this was an actual proper game is I wouldn't just make the player disappear. I'd even change the state of the game to game over or high scores and main menu or whatever. Or I would make the player respawn. So what we need here, anyway, player. We're going to do the health bar as well. Health bar, not nat. That's not at all what I want. Texture. Texture and rectangle health rectangle. Also, mouse state past mouse. That's for when I click on the player. Is it nearly Christmas? No, no, it's not. Player equals new player. Weird. I'm getting hot ears right now wearing this headset. I don't appreciate that. What's this position? I'll give it 100 health. Health texture equals content dot load. Oh, I've done it again. Only gonna done it again. That doesn't even make sense. How can it be that? The rectangle for my health bar I'm going to do my update method, but first I will do mouse state mouse equals mouse dot get state and then do mouse not mouse even rectangle mouse rectangle equals new rectangle. X, mouse dot Y, 1, 1. That's just so I can click the player and have him die. Health. Rectangle equals new rectangle. Position doesn't really matter where you put this, but it's the width that's the important part. What you want this to be set as is player.health. So since I have player.health set at the minute to 100, that the health rectangle will be 100 pixels wide. So every time the player's health goes down, so will the width of the health rectangle, or the health bar. Player.update and past mouse equals mouse. Right, I'm going to draw all this on and then got the what to do stuff. Draw the health rectangle texture and even health rectangle and then color dot white. Player dot draw and sprite batch dot end. Okay, so that's all drawn on the screen and all initialized. What we need now is if mouse rectangle dot intersects with player dot rectangle. And open bracket mouse where are you dot left button equals button state dot pressed and past mouse equals dot left button equals press button dot released, then player dot health take equals 10. I need to draw my mouse on. Every time I do this, I always forget. Yes. Right. Let me run that again. Okay, so I've got my health there at 100 pixels wide, or at least it should be. I've got my player. If I click on him, it's gone down a little bit. Oh, by about 10%, I'd say. Click him another 8-9 times. No, I'll do 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's got one click left before he dies. Gone. Ding. So what you could do, instead of in the draw method there, in the update method or wherever, you could put if health is less than or equal to zero, then player.respawn, and then have a method in the player class, respawn to equal a certain position, or player.die, and then when player dies, the state changes of the game to whatever. So it's up to you how you want to go around that. Thank you for watching.